Hello friends, today we are going to start with the sixth unit, that is positive displacement compressor, subject applied thermodynamics, second year mechanical engineering. Now when we start this lecture, let me tell you that first we will see the fundamentals of a compressor, the basic definitions, then the work done derivation. And in the next video, we will start with some numericals, that is the basic numericals. Now let us begin. Now what is a compressor? A compressor is a device which compresses the air, and this stored air can be used for different applications. Now those can be many other applications in pneumatic industries, in automobile industry, in mining industries, and such other applications. So starting with this, first we will see the efficiency. So first is the isothermal efficiency. Now what is the isothermal efficiency? Isothermal efficiency is a simple definition in which isothermal work done upon the actual work done. Isothermal work input upon actual work input. So this ratio is called as the isothermal efficiency. Next, what is the polytropic efficiency? Now, polytropic efficiency is nothing but the polytropic work done upon actual work. Now you can see the similarity: isothermal work done, polytropic work done. So in coming slides we will see this. But here the denominator remains same. Actual work done is always at the denominator, what we spend. Moving ahead, the adiabatic efficiency. Adiabatic efficiency or isentropic efficiency. Now similarly, you can see what is this efficiency? Adiabatic work input upon actual work input. So this is again a definition for the adiabatic efficiency, or also called as the isothermal efficiency. But make this clear that in all the points, all the efficiencies, the denominator remains same, that is the actual work input. So in the coming slides you will see this isotropic, isothermal, polytropic and adiabatic work inputs that will be covered. Now to start with, the work done by the on the compressor, that derivation, we have to have some assumptions. So first assumption is the there is no clearance, so clearance volume is neglected. So this is the first assumption. Next assumption, the working fluid is a perfect gas. Next assumption, there is no friction loss. The friction losses are also neglected, or no friction loss is present. Next, there is no wire drawing effects in the walls or in the pipeline. So this is also another important assumption where you can start. We have to assume this before starting the derivation, work done derivation. Now let us move ahead. Let us go through the PV diagram. Now we can clearly see in this PV diagram, see this is the PV diagram for a compressor, in which B to C is the compression. Now in compression again there are three types: isothermal, polytropic and adiabatic. So you can clearly see, well, it is been shown. So this is isothermal, this is polytropic and this is isothermal. So isothermal means what? The temperature does not change. Polytropic means there is a polytropic index. So this polytropic index is n value, and it varies from 1.0 to 1.4. That is the range, but generally it is between 1.10 to 1.30, in this range. And This gamma, the adiabatic index, it is, you know that it, the value is 1.4. Already we have studied this in the basic thermodynamics, semester 1. And PV raised to 1 is equal to constant. This is nothing but the isothermal process. So here you can see that there is no clearance volume. This A, suction, compression and delivery, that is constant pressure rejection, that is air output. And similarly, you can clearly see C, B, C. This process is adiabatic, reversible adiabatic. B, C dash is polytropic. B, C double dash is isothermal. Now, theoretically, isothermal is beneficial. And practically, PV raised to gamma, that is reversible adiabatic process, is not desirable. But generally, the compression process happens in between these two, that is the polytropic, and that is the reason why we have a polytropic index here. And similarly, the TS diagram is also represented. So if you see the constant pressure lines P1 and P2 here, these constant pressure lines, you can clearly see B, C, B, C dash and B, C double dash. Okay. Moving ahead, now clearly see the notations O, E, F, B, C, D, A. So this diagram you need to remember. Now we are going to start with the calculations for work of compression and efficiencies. So today's aim is this. Now reversible adiabatic work. Now if you now what is the definition? Area under the diagram ABCD. Now if you see this ABCD, it can be written like this. If you clearly see that diagram, area of ODCE plus area of ECBF minus the area of OAPF. You see the diagram, you can come to know that we are interested in this area, and it can be written in this form. Now if you see area ODCE is PV, P into V. Similarly, area ECBF is P2 V2 minus P1 V1 upon gamma minus 1 minus P1 V1, that is the area of OAPF. Now when you simplify this, you will come to know that P2 V2, multiply this here, gamma minus 1 plus P2 V2 minus P1 V1 minus P1 V1 upon gamma minus 1. So please remember, this is for the adiabatic process. Now simplifying this, now how to simplify this? P2 V2 gamma minus P2 V2 plus P2 V2 minus P1 V1 upon gamma minus 1 minus P1 V1. Now you just have to simplify this, and you can cancel these terms. So these terms will be cancelled. Okay. Now the simplified form will be P2 V2 gamma minus P1 V1 minus gamma minus 1 P1 V1 upon gamma minus 1. Just you are multiplying this here, nothing else. Okay. Now another simplified form, P2 V2 gamma minus P1 V1 minus P1 V1 gamma, multiply this, simplify this bracket, plus minus minus plus P1 V1 upon gamma minus 1. Again this P1 V1 plus P1 V1 will get cancelled. Now taking the common terms out, gamma upon gamma minus 1 into bracket. Now you can clearly see here, gamma is common here. So gamma upon gamma minus 1, this term from here, here you have to take gamma common. Okay, when you take gamma common, P2 V2 minus P1 V1 upon this term, that is gamma minus 1. Now again taking P1 V1 common out of this bracket, so dividing to both the terms, so gamma upon gamma minus 1 P1 V1 into bracket P2 V2 upon P1 V1 minus 1. So this, name this as equation number 1. Now you know that P1 V1 raised to gamma is equal to P2 V2 raised to gamma, compression process. So this is adiabatic compression process. You have studied this in basic thermodynamics. Similarly, V2 upon V1 is equal to P1 upon P2 raised to the power 1 upon gamma. Raised to the power 1 upon gamma. So this you have already studied in basic thermodynamics for adiabatic compression process. Now see, to this term you have to multiply both the sides by P2 upon P1 and P2 upon P1, multiply to LHS and RHS. So you will get P2 V2 upon P1 V1. Again you are multiplying P2 upon P1 multiplied by P1 upon P2 raised to the power 1 minus gamma. Now when you simplify this, now you have to take the reciprocal. Now this term, when you will convert P1 upon P2, it will be simplified as 1 upon gamma minus 1. So if you take it common, so it is explained here. So it will be the simplified form. This will be the simplified form of the previous thing. Okay, name this as equation number 2. Correct? Now, from equation 1 and 2, you can write work done is equal to gamma upon gamma minus 1 P1 V1. You put these values in the above equation. You will clearly see that P1 V1 is present and P2 V2 upon P1 V1 is simplified in this form. Okay, it is simplified in this form. You are putting this value here. P2 V2 upon P1 V1 is equal to P2 upon P1 raised to the power gamma minus 1 upon gamma. You are putting it here in that equation. Minus 1. So this equation, but P1 V1 is equal to MRT1. So putting this value again in the above equation, you will get reversible adiabatic work done is equal to gamma upon gamma minus 1 multiplied by MRT1, because P1 V1 is equal to MRT1 into bracket P2 upon P1 raised to the power gamma minus 1 upon gamma minus 1. So this equation gives you the reversible adiabatic work done. Very important equation. It is also asked in the examination. So similarly, we can find out for the polytropic work done and your isothermal work done. Okay. Moving ahead. Now, in a single case, single stage compressor, so that the law of compression PV raised to N is equal to constant. So this is a polytropic process because N is the polytropic index. The value of N is less than gamma. Less than gamma means gamma is 1.4. So it will always be less than 1.4. So substituting the value of gamma by N, because this is a polytropic work. So polytropic work can be written by using the previous equation as WP, that is polytropic, into bracket N upon N minus 1 P1 V1 bracket complete P2 upon P1 raised to the power. So here it is 1, by mistake it is written, here it is 1. N minus 1 upon N minus 1. Okay. Similarly, isothermal work done. So isothermal work done, there is a separate definition for this, already studied in basic thermodynamics. So it can be written as isothermal work done P1 V1 log to the base E V1 upon V2, or P1 V1 log to the base E P2 upon P1, and P1 V1 is equal to MRT1. Okay, so this value, so it is already a part of basic thermodynamics. We have already studied this. Moving ahead, now what is the indicated power? Now indicated power is known as air power required to drive the compressor. Air power required to drive the compressor. So indicated power is W into N upon 60 multiplied by 1000 in kilowatts. So here small n is the number of strokes per minute completed by the compressor. Number of strokes completed by the compressor. Similarly, capital N is the speed of the compressor in RPM. Small n is equal to capital N for single acting compressor. Remember this thing, because in numericals also this is asked. And N is equal to 2 into capital N for double acting compressor. Okay. Moving ahead, what is mechanical efficiency? Now it is defined as the ratio of indicated power to the power required to run the compressor is called as the brake power. So that is the brake power, or also called as the shaft power, or also called as the motor power. Okay, so in simple words, mechanical efficiency is what? Indicated power upon the brake power. So brake power is also called as the motor power or shaft power here, and indicated power is at the top. So that is theoretical parameter, you can say. Now what is adiabatic efficiency? Adiabatic efficiency is nothing but the adiabatic power upon brake power. Adiabatic power upon brake power. Okay, and mechanical efficiency is indicated power upon brake power. So thank you friends, thank you very much.